All right, guys, question five. I'm going to combine two because they're essentially asking the same thing. I'll read both, but I'm going to answer both at the same time. 5A, let's call it. What theoretical framework exists for a correlational research? 5B, what is the theoretical framework of the case study? This really necessitates talking about theoretical framework, which is a chapter one construct, not a chapter three construct, although we can't get rid of it, or we can't ignore it, because part of the theoretical framework is our design and our instrumentation and our data analyses. Okay? Here's what we have to differentiate, though, or make sure we're clear about. Theoretical framework is the body of knowledge necessary to situate a given study amongst all studies. Now, think about that. That's very broad. Well, it is because it's a framework of a theory, right? And theory really should be theoretical, which is why it's called theoretical framework, because it's plural, it's not singular. So it's all the things that I have to know as a reader or be aware of so that when I'm reading your study, I can kind of put it in its hierarchy in this field, right? So the field's a hierarchy. There's all these studies, right? And there's a main study that defines the field. That's what's at the top of the hierarchy. Your study is trying to enter into that hierarchy. How do I do that as a reader? Because you don't do that as the author. The reader does that. And now, if you're paying attention, that's going to be slightly different for each reader because they have a different frame of reference for themselves or a different understanding of the field, which is why you, as the reader, write that section in chapter one because you want to control it. You want to tell the reader, here's the theoretical framework for this study. Here's all the things that you need to know so that you can situate my work in its proper place amongst all studies in this field. Okay? So these two questions, 5A and 5B, are essentially the same question just for two different designs, correlational research and case study. Now, I'm going to assume the case study, 5B, implicitly wants to ask about qualitative case study. Because remember, I think it was question two, I mentioned that you can have quantitative case study. That's valid. And I'm going to juxtapose that against correlational research, which, as you guys know, is only ever quantitative. Okay, so what do I need to understand in order to understand correlation or relationship between variables? Well, I need to understand the hierarchy of research design. So, what differentiates correlational from descriptive and experimentation? What differentiates the types of correlational research? Because there's two, there's explanatory and there's predictive. Okay? So, what are you doing? Are you trying to explain that there's a relationship present, or are you trying to predict a relationship? They're both correlational, but they're not the same thing. Okay? What else goes into that? Well, you have to deal with the subject in the context of the study itself, or what we could say is the topic. What about the problem? What about all the tangential things that have to be in place to support how I'm going to go about measuring whether there is or is not a relationship? That's all part of the theoretical framework. So there's not a theoretical framework for correlational research in and of itself, apart from the first things I mentioned, what makes it correlational, what makes it not something else other than correlational, and that stuff. What is a variable? What's an explanatory variable? What's a predictive variable? Now, you don't want to go into too much of that detail because the detail of it isn't the theoretical framework. That might be a little confusing, so let me say it again. The detail of things like explanatory versus predictive variables is not necessarily part of the theoretical framework. The abstraction of correlational research is part of the theoretical framework. And then true for a case study. Within the theoretical framework of that case study, why are you studying central phenomenon? Like, what is that relative to non-central phenomenon? Always think about the juxtaposition when you use terms. If I call something primary, then that implies that something else is secondary. So not only why is that thing primary, but why are those other things secondary? You always have to keep stuff like that in mind. You want to be sure that you're explaining both sides of that. Don't only explain one side, right? Because it's only one side of the story. You want to write the whole story, the whole narrative. So you can kind of look at the same thing for case study. Why case study? Why not something else? Why qualitative, not quantitative? What else about this case? What else about central phenomenon? And how we, as participants in the world, how do we relate to central phenomenon? And that kind of gets into whatever your central phenomenon is, but there you go. There's five with two parts.